something a little different today. I found myself this week with nothing to talk about. Not that I don't have anything to talk about, I just don't have anything ready to go. So, I decided to respond to a request that someone made about a month ago. This person had noticed one of the books on my shelves and asked what else I had, asked if I would do a bookshelf tour, and I thought about it, and I decided, yeah, I guess I can do that. So I have cleaned up a little bit. I've dusted the shelves off so that they'll be nice and presentable. I don't want to show you dusty shelves because then you'll think that I don't touch any of my books. It's not true. I do read them. I do not have what I would consider a fancy book collection. A lot of what I own are things that I inherited. I have books from my mom, I have books from my grandparents, I have a lot of books that I got from library book sales and from used bookstores. I have not done anything like this before, not because it didn't occur to me. I did think that maybe people would be curious, because I know that when I'm watching videos and people have books behind them, I spend a lot of my time like this, looking to see what they have on their shelves. So I do know that there's a curiosity out there. I didn't really want to do it because it's gonna be a long video, and I don't like making long videos, I don't like editing long videos, and I don't like holding a camera up for that long, but, it's for you, so I hope you enjoy it. One other thing before we get to the books, and that is the question of, do I have a Goodreads account? I've been asked this twice already, and I'm very flattered by the interest. I'm honored that you would want to know. The answer that I gave was, yes, I do, but I keep it private. By private, I mean anybody could stumble upon it on Goodreads. I just haven't publicly broadcast the link. I haven't made it, don't mind the traffic, I haven't made it openly connected with Jerome Weaselberry. Do you know what I mean? It's not listed under Jerome Weaselberry. That is strictly my YouTube name. It's not my real name. I hope that's not an earth-shattering revelation to anybody. If it is, sorry! However, I am considering sharing the link with you. It wouldn't be tremendously exciting. I'm not a big Goodreads personality. I do go on there every time I finish a book and add it, and I have lots of books I want to read on there. I don't write very many reviews. I don't have very many friends. I'm very private. I'm not a good social media person, period. I don't do Twitter. I tried it. I didn't like it. I don't have an Instagram. I am practically a Facebook non-entity these days. I post like 4 times a year. This whole YouTube thing is actually an exception. I'm a shy person, and I'm shy on the internet as much as I am in real life. But even on YouTube, I'm not very good at the social media aspect of it because I stink at leaving comments. I love getting them, it's really fun, it makes it so much more interesting, but I'm not good at reciprocating that. If any of you out there watching have YouTube comment anxiety, I understand. I am right there with you. I have typed up many comments and then decided not to leave them just because I felt like what I have to say isn't really that important, and I'll just go back in my shell now. Really, I'm a social media turtle. So anyway, I'm thinking about sharing the Goodreads link with you. I haven't completely committed yet. I don't know. Why don't you look at this bookshelf tour, and if you really want me to, I'll think harder about it. I don't know. We'll see. Okay, I'm gonna stop talking now and we'll get on with the tour because that's what you're really here to see. I guess I'll start right here with what's always behind me. This is the main bookshelf. It has 4 levels. I'm not really sure what would be the best way to do this because I feel like if I pull out every single book, we'll be here forever. But at the same time, I know that you would like to see every single book, so I'll try to keep it quick. This is a book of my mom's. I think it's Christian fiction. These are my two Jane Austen books, Emma and Pride and Prejudice. This is a copy of 100 Ray Bradbury Stories. I have not read all of them, but I've read a lot of them, and yeah, Ray Bradbury's writing is awesome. Oh, this was something I said I was not going to do. I said I was not going to go through and editorialize on every single book. Here's Fahrenheit 451. Here's my really dinky 70s copy of Jane Eyre. Here's Villette, also by Charlotte Bronte. Pilgrim's Progress. How do you pronounce this? My Antonia? Antonia? I don't know. I read it. Here's my copy of Don Quixote. It's one of those books that you get it and then it sits on your shelf for a long time. This is how far I got in it. One of these days. Up here is Red Badge of Courage, The Last of the Mohicans, The Good Earth, Death in the Castle, which is another Pearl Buck book, completely different from The Good Earth, and Jaws. I have a Michael Crichton hardcover here, Pirate Latitudes. I have three more Michael Crichton books up here. The Andromeda Strain, which I started, but I couldn't get very far into it. I mean to try again really soon. I've seen the movie. My mom loves it. Jurassic Park, which I read, loved it! And Ears of the Dead, which I didn't really like that much. Now, this is my complicated organization of the Charles Dickens books that I own. I don't really know what I was thinking when I organized all these books like this. So what I've got for Dickens is Bleak House, David Copperfield, Great Expectations, come on out, Hard Times. This one I only got this far into it. Over here I have Oliver Twist and A Tale of Two Cities, and it's stuck. Come on. And then down here, if we move the owl out of the way, I've got The Pickwick Papers, which was hilarious, The Old Curiosity Shop, what's on that anyway? That's a copy of my mom's, and The Mystery of Edwin Drood, and then I have this collection that came from my grandparents' attic, or was it in a closet? It's a great collection of books, I love it, but you can't really read anything in them. The only thing that I've read from this collection is Nicholas Nickleby. And it was not impossible reading it in here, but it's an old book, and you want to be really careful with it. It also has illustrations, and that's really nice, but I don't want anything to happen to it. So when I was going to read Bleak House, which I do have here, I decided to read it in the paperback edition instead. And that's probably what I'll do when I read Our Mutual Friend, which I'm really looking forward to because I really liked the early 2000s adaptation of it, and so I've always wanted to read it, but I started reading it in this edition and it just did not work for me. Going back up here to the stuff we skipped, I have The Moonstone by Wilkie Collins. This I just picked up last fall. Here's Volume 1 and Volume 2 of The Complete Sherlock Holmes. I've only read a chunk of Volume 1, just finished The Hound of the Baskervilles. I'm not really a huge Sherlock Holmes fan, but I did like that one. Here are my two Alexandre Dumas books, The Count of Monte Cristo, which I picked up at a library book sale. I've only gotten halfway through that one, and The Three Musketeers, which I loved. Here are my two Dostoevsky books, this cute little Barnes & Noble miniature edition of Crime and Punishment, and The Brothers Karamazov, which I don't even know where I got this book. Did I inherit this? Did I take it from somebody? I don't know. But this is how far I got in that one. I was trying to read it in the car on a road trip, and it's just too many names, too many people. I kept falling asleep, and it was not the right time. Some other time, I will tackle it again. I have An American Tragedy by Theodore Dreiser, and The House on the Strand by Daphne du Maurier. Okay, back to this shelf. I apologize for all of the back and forth, but I'm trying to get through all of these books. Here's The Sound and the Fury by William Faulkner. He's right next to my F. Scott Fitzgerald books, which I thought was appropriate. So I've got The Great Gatsby, Tender is the Night, and This Side of Paradise. Here are my Jasper Forday books. That's how I always pronounce his name. I have Shades of Grey, which was a really fascinating book, and he's promised a sequel for such a long time, and by now I can't even remember where things left off. I can barely remember what the book was about. Speaking of books that he never came out with a sequel for, I have the two Nursery Crimes books, The Big Over Easy and The Fourth Bear. But there have been abundant sequels of the Thursday Next series, which I really liked for the first few books. I thought The Air Affair was amazing, and I really enjoyed the next two, Lost in a Good Book and The Well of Lost Plots. I loved all the literary references and the idea of jumping into the books and meeting the literary characters in the flesh. I love that kind of thing. But as the books went on, they weren't the same anymore. It was a series that should have ended. Up here I have an old beaten copy of James Hilton's Lost Horizon, Washington Irving's The Legend of Sleepy Hollow, E.M. Forster's Howard's End and A Room with a View, C.S. Forrester's The African Queen, Oliver Goldsmith's The Vicar of Wakefield, Hannah Green's I Never Promised You a Rose Garden, and George Eliot's Silas Marner. Silas Marner and Howard's End are the only books in that stack that I have not read yet. And over here, excuse me, here we have my copy of The Phantom of the Opera by Gaston Leroux. How many times did I read this obsessively when I was 16, 17, 18? Stephen King's The Girl Who Loved Tom Gordon, Kon-Tiki by Thor Heyerdahl, and The Hunchback of Notre Dame by Victor Hugo. Down here I have Lord of the Flies by William Golding. I have The Mayor of Casterbridge, Far from the Madding Crowd, and Tess of the D'Urbervilles, all by Thomas Hardy. This is my Nathaniel Hawthorne section. I've got I think this might be a first edition, don't quote me on that, of Twice Told Tales. I've got this really ugly edition of The Scarlet Letter. I really like The Scarlet Letter. I've written countless papers on it. The Marble Faun, which I have not read. The House of the Seven Gables, which I have read twice. Here's The Marble Faun. House of the Seven Gables, and The Blithedale Romance, which I read once. It was okay. And I have William Dean Howells' The Rise of Silas Lapham, Hannah Hernard's Hinds Feet on High Places, The Poisonwood Bible by Barbara Kingsolver, and Moby Dick by Herman Melville. I'm sorry if I'm going too fast, but I really am trying to just speed through these things. Another owl who's in the way. Okay, did you hear that? That was my knee cracking. Inherit the Wind, Scarlet Pimpernel. Ooh, spooky. I really hated this cover of Frankenstein when I was little. I have a lot of books that belonged to siblings that became mine somehow when they went away to school or moved out or whatever. They didn't give them to me, I just took them. And so now they are part of my collection. I've got Jan Martel's Life of Pi, The Heart is a Lonely Hunter by Carson McCullers, Gone with the Wind by Margaret Mitchell, Stepping Heavenward by Elizabeth Prentice, 1984 by George Orwell, The Bell Jar by Sylvia Plath, Sarah's Key by Tatiana de Rosne, The Best of Saki by, it's by Saki, Dragonwick by, Seton is the last name. I don't remember the person's first name. I only got that because it's a movie with Vincent Price and Gene Tierney, a gothic thriller romance thing. This is a nice old fat one, The Complete Stories and Poems of Edgar Allan Poe. This came from my grandfather's house, and when it's complete, it means it's complete. It's got his comedy stories in there too, not just the scary ones. So that's nice to have in my collection. On the Beach by Neville Shute. Here are my John Steinbeck books. I've got The Grapes of Wrath. Not very interesting cover. The Pearl of Mice and Men. And East of Eden. Harriet Beecher Stowe's Uncle Tom's Cabin. A collection of Tennyson's poems. Illustrated. This is another very fragile book that was in my grandfather's living room for a long time. It's inscribed From Father to Mother, Christmas 1878. So this is another family heirloom that I have to take very nice care of. Tolstoy's War and Peace, Jamie Langston Turner's The Sun Catchers and Sometimes the Light Surprises, Leon Uris's Exodus, The Snake Pit, which I also got that because I like the movie with Olivia de Havilland, T.H. White's The Once and Future King, Laurie Wick's To Know Her by Name, Oscar Wilde's The Picture of Dorian Gray, Leave Her to Heaven, another book that I got because I like the movie with Gene Tierney. Here's a Wodehouse book, Jeeves and the Tie That Binds. It's not with my other Wodehouse books because, I don't know why it's not with the other ones. Marcus Zusak's The Book Thief. Here it is. The book that started this whole bookshelf tour thing. And this is a collection of classic Christmas stories that was a gift for Christmas one year. And up here I have another collection of Edgar Allan Poe stories. This one titled The Pit and the Pendulum. It has, I don't know, 4 or 5 stories in it. A copy of Gulliver's Travels that is not mine, but I have it anyway. Betty Smith's A Tree Grows in Brooklyn and Tomorrow Will Be Better. And up here we have, oh boy, a collection called Short Shorts, The Shortest Stories. 2 H.G. Wells books, The Time Machine and The The War of the Worlds. The Invisible Man is over on another shelf. Ethan Frome by Edith Wharton, and The Glass Menagerie by Tennessee Williams, which is a play, and Mary Stuart's 9 Coaches Waiting, which is a gothic romance that I got for Christmas just this year. I'm gonna skip the last shelf because it's not actually books, it's music. Okay, so that's the main bookshelf. That's what's behind me when I'm filming. To my left is the juvenile bookshelf, which is sitting on top of another bookshelf. Very precarious. If there was ever a big earthquake, then I'd be in trouble. This does not hold all of my juvenile books. The rest of them are in a box somewhere. That's where my Magic Treehouse books are, and some other things that I can't really remember. So we've got more owls to take out of the way, and I'm probably not going to take books out and show them to you just because I don't want the shelf to topple down on me. That would really be a bad way to do the video. So these are my, I say that as I reach to pull the book out, stupid. These are my Louisa May Alcott books, An Old Fashioned Girl, 8 Cousins, and Rosenbloom. I read 8 Cousins and Rosenbloom so much it's ridiculous. These are my 3 Investigators books. I really liked those mysteries when I was a kid. The True Confessions of Charlotte Doyle, Alice's Adventures in Wonderland, and Through the Looking Glass in one book. James and the Giant Peach and the Twits by Roald Dahl. These are my Bailey School Kids books, which I already did a review of. Here's The City of Ember, which I did a review of. This is my dad's copy of The Tower Treasure, the first Hardy Boys book. I wasn't really a big Hardy Boys fan myself, but I do have this one, and I read a couple others. They're probably in that box that's somewhere else around here with all the other books in it. These are my 2 Julie Andrews books, Mandy and the Last of the Really Great Wang Doodles, which I recently reviewed, The Neverending Story, The Black Stallion, Bandit's Moon, which I keep meaning to reread just because I don't remember it. I remember that I liked it, but I don't remember what it was about. The Phantom Tollbooth, which is a very much loved book. My only Nancy Drew book that I own. All the others belong to my mom and my sisters. This one I got in a book order. It's book number 150 in the series, Mystery at Morsi Manor. The House on Hackman's Hill by Joan Lowery Nixon. Ugh, scariest book I ever read, or at least scariest book I read when I was a kid. I have 3 Babysitter's Club books. I have Claudia and the Mystery at the Museum, Christy and the Mystery Train, and Mallory Hates Boys and Jim. I think they must have come in a set from a book order, because I'm not sure how I would have picked those ones. I enjoyed the Babysitter's Club mystery books. They were fun. I have the 3 Shiloh books, Shiloh, Shiloh Season, and Saving Shiloh. That's the one with the dog. Here is my copy of The Secret of Nim, which is really called Mrs. Frisbee and the Rats of Nim, but I have the movie copy. Sweet Valley Twins. I didn't really read very many of these books, but I had this. I got it from some fair thing, big for Christmas, and I read it a lot. Anne Rinaldi's Time Enough for Drums. Oh my goodness, that was one of the most romantic books that I ever read when I was little. I have 2 of the Wayside School books. I think this is the second one, Wayside School is Falling Down, and the 3rd one, Wayside School Gets a Little Stranger. Here is The Egypt Game, The Bomb by Theodore Taylor, The Trouble with Tuck, oh, which is also by Theodore Taylor. That's about a dog that goes blind, I believe. Sad book. Smart Dog. Got a lot of dog books in here, which is funny because I have never owned a dog. Smart Dog, Peppermints. Oh, wow, these books are really stuck in here. I can't get the last ones out. Peppermints in the Parlor, Stuart Little, and The Dollhouse Murders. Up here, I have my Animal Ark books by Ben M. Baglio. I've got a whole bunch of them. Wow, it's really blurry. I hope it hasn't been that blurry all along. Up here is The Horse and His Boy, which I got from a library book sale. It's the only Narnia book that I own. And these are the 4 Ella Montgomery books that I owned. My sister had all of the Anne books and the Emily books, as well as Magic for Marigold. And I had The Blue Castle, The Golden Road, and Pat of Silver Bush, and its sequel, Mistress Pat. So between us, we had quite a lot of them. Okay, down here I have this little bell that has an owl on it that somebody gave me. And moving this guy out of the way, come on. And here's my Boba Fett. He's now good to me dead. Put Captain Solo in the cargo hold. Yep, he talks. Okay, so down here I've got this Scholastic Classics set that I got in a book order when I was in 6th grade, I think. It has Dracula by Bram Stoker, Black Beauty by Anna Sewell, The Raven and Other Poems by Edgar Allan Poe. So what is that, the 4th collection of Poe that I have? Those are just poems. I have White Fang and The Call of the Wild by Jack London, A Christmas Carol by Charles Dickens, The Secret Garden, and A Little Princess by Frances Hodgson Burnett, Wuthering Heights by Emily Bronte, another copy of Pride and Prejudice by Jane Austen, Louisa May Alcott's Little Women, The Adventures of Tom Sawyer by Mark Twain, 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea by Jules Verne, and The Invisible Man by H.G. Wells. I am pretty sure that I read all of these with the exception of Black Beauty. I read most of Black Beauty in another edition that I got from the library when I was a kid, and I never finished it. Okay, so next to those, I have these. These 3 books are by Helen Wells. They are part of a relatively obscure series of mysteries. Vicky Barr is a young woman who becomes a flight attendant, and she goes on all these adventures, and there's always a mystery involved. We have the 1st one, the 3rd one, and I can't remember which number this one is. And I always wanted to read more, but they were just impossible to find. My older sister got them a long time ago, I think. And at the same time, or a similar time that they got those, they got these Judy Bolton books. And I have talked about Judy Bolton in a video a long time ago. Judy Bolton, my favorite of the old girl detective books of that time period. I've got all of these, which are nice old original copies. And then I've got the new paperback reprints. That's pretty much it for the juvenile bookshelf. I've got some trivia books and some American Girl things. And here's my 50 States Quarters book, still full of all those quarters. Down here I have my prized The Spider and the Fly hardcover picture book. These are my Robert Tsubota pop-up books, which I have reviewed. These are a bunch of textbooks, English literature and American literature of world literature. This is a Spanish literature textbook, which is totally in Spanish. I can't believe I was at a point where I could read all of this. And this is another family heirloom. This is, I believe it's my grandfather's book of Shakespeare. It has his penciled in notes in it, and I used it in a class for one semester. It was really fun to do that. Had to be really careful with it, but it was really special to do that. The next shelf is familiar to those of you who saw the Georgia Tare video I did. These are all the Georgia Tare books that I have, and they're all here because there wasn't any other place to put them. And then over here are my 5 Terry Pratchett books. This is where the rest of my PG Wodehouse books are. I have 6 of them. And this is where I keep this boxed set of Shakespeare, two books of tragedies and 2 books of comedies. It's not a great collection. And this is a stack of books that aren't really mine, but I somehow have ended up with them in my room. We're gonna skip the last shelf because it's all binders and notebooks and textbooks. Okay, the last bookcase is over here by the window. I have filmed here a couple of times. This is my mystery shelf. This is where I keep most of the mysteries, with a few exceptions that just wouldn't fit. This shelf is dominated by Agatha Christie, I would say. These are all Agatha Christie. These are all Agatha Christie. More Agatha Christie all the way up to here, and then there's a few up there. Used ones, and more used ones, and then these are all new copies. Lots of Agatha Christie books. I am a fan of hers, although I haven't read one in a very long time. Here we have 4 Jane Austen mysteries. They're by Stephanie Barron. The first one is Jane and the Unpleasantness at Scargrave Manor. I found this book randomly in a used bookstore somewhere, and I thought it sounded intriguing, so I picked it up and I read it and I liked it. So I asked for more for Christmas or my birthday, and I got them. My interest in the series kind of petered out, though. I think I got partway through Jane and the Wandering Eye. I don't think I ever read Jane and the Genius of the Place. Here are 3 Perry Mason books. Most of the Perry Mason books that I read, I got out of the library. So I don't own very many of those, but I do own this Perry Mason 7 Complete Novels omnibus, which has a whole bunch more. So that is too big to fit on the shelf, so it just sits here with the Complete Father Brown by G.K. Chesterton on top. And finishing where I was over here, I have my Nio Marsh books. Those feature the detective Roderick Allen. I'm a big fan of him. I have 7 of those, actually 8, I think, if you include Death in a White Tie, which is up here. It doesn't fit. It's a different edition. It drives me kind of crazy. And here are my Rex Stout books. Those feature Nero Wolfe and Archie Goodwin, more favorites of mine. And there's another copy over here, which doesn't fit, but oh well, it's okay, the more the merrier. Here are 3 Georgia Tare mysteries, Footsteps in the Dark, Why Shoot a Butler, And this, which I picked up somewhere, No Wind of Blame. And then I also have Gaston Leroux's The Mystery of the Yellow Room, which I never finished. Okay, so at this point, my arm is getting really tired and my voice is starting to run out, so I'm not gonna go through this shelf in depth. It's got all the nonfiction in it. It's a wide range. I've got my film books and I've got mountain books. This is one thing that I'm really happy to have found. It's editor to author, The Letters of Maxwell Perkins. He worked with F. Scott Fitzgerald and Ernest Hemingway and several famous authors from that time period. And it's really interesting to read the letters that he wrote to them, what he has to say for advice, and just his observations on different things. Yeah, so a whole bunch of different books here. Some spiritual books, books that belong to my mom. Yeah, it's a big mix. So those are all my books. I hope you enjoyed that. I hope that it wasn't too fast, and also that it wasn't too long. I know that this was a long video, and I'm sorry. I don't like doing long things like that, but if you've stuck around this long, thank you very much. I really appreciate it. I hope you found something to interest you. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them, comments. If you would rather send me a private comment because you have YouTube commenter anxiety, then that's fine too. Thanks for watching. Bye!